He wore number 5 in high school and in college, and Tress Way wears number 5 for the Commanders. And then we went through all the numbers, and they're almost all taken. Like, oh, maybe he'll switch to 15. No, that's Dax Milne. Maybe he'll switch to this, and it's taken by Frankie Louvu. All the numbers were taken. Anyway, Cakes and I consummated a bet at the end of the show, and I was like, well, put it in the bet book. And he was like, my bet book's right here, I believe is what Cakes said. He pointed to his dome.
I did, yeah.
And I gave him the field.
Mm-hmm.
And not, I don't know, 6 hours later, 8 hours later, it comes out that Tress Way indeed has given Jaden Daniels his number. Here is Tress Way doing the act of giving his uniform number to Jaden Daniels.
Guys, this is Tress Way. I understand that there's been a little bit of hype going on about a certain number. Maybe you could take a look around. Maybe a little bit behind me, you'll see if there's any big news. But I think there may be somebody new in town.
And Jaden then emerges from the video, standing behind him.
So now what's interesting is, I guess, I know you have more, that they're just doing, they're not doing it for cash. They're doing it for like a trip to an LSU-Oklahoma game in the future when he retires, which is cool. Send his family to the game. But what I found most interesting is Tress apparently immediately said no when first asked, or when it was first broached about. He's like, no, it's my number, 5.
Tress got it. I should have stuck to his guns. What's he doing here?
No, but I think at the end of the day, he probably did make the right decision, and he's going to go down sort of iconic here. So I guess you have audio of him talking to Santana about it, and he gets kind of emotional here. And you know, listen, this team's been pretty awful during his entire tenure here, but he's been one of the stalwarts, right? He's been a captain for 4 years. Presumably, this will be his 5th year being a captain. I would say it's safe to say he's got to be about as beloved as any punter could
be. He's been one of the few bright spots on the team in a dark era.
This generous move by him, I think, is going to bode very, very well for him.
I think about... Think about the first time I came and
why did I do that?
See, man, no, it's all good. It's
what's your
thing?
We played together, man. We played together.
No, man. And I was one with Chicago. Yeah. I just didn't like it. Yeah. I got there, they gave me one, and I got picked up here on the waiver wire. Mm-hmm. And it was the first time I felt wanted. Like it was like, hey, like they picked me.
Yeah.
And I came in, 5 was sitting there, and I was like, yeah. I was like, I like that.
But, yeah.
So it just kind of, this is harder than I thought.
It's all good, man.
But I think about, I was talking to my wife, and I've been fortunate enough to have been voted team captain 4 times.
Mm-hmm.
And if I get voted captain again in my career, that C gets filled in. And I was like, man. It's going to be weird if I give up the number. The first time I get that C filled in, it's going to be a different number.
Yeah.
And my wife said, why do you have the C like in the first place? Like, what gives you the C? And just feel like there's just so much excitement around this organization, hands down the most I have ever seen. Mm-hmm. Like just all of the excitement building and building and building. And I just feel like this is just a very small part that I could do. You got a rookie coming in, can't imagine what's going on in his head and his heart. And you know, I'm there for him on 4th down if we have to give the ball away. But maybe this is an example I could show him, hey, I'm here for you now too.
Yeah. So
well, if he doesn't get voted captain after that sort of emotion and, you know, like just being a good dude to the rookie by giving him the number that he knows that Jaden Daniels has worn and that he wants clearly.
Mm-hmm.
Like, can I place a wager on Tress Way being voted or named a team captain in 2024?
He's got to be.
Because that's the sort of leadership that you want on every team.
Well, he's got to be, especially if you're going to have like an offensive captain, defensive captain, a special teams guy.
I mean,
he's got to be the guy.
Yeah, I mean, it's just a dude you love.
How surprised were you, Cakes? Because this happened the day we made a bet.
I wasn't that surprised. I mean, I just run bad sometimes. Sometimes I run bad. But I'm happy that our listener that came to the Roadhouse premiere gave us a bunch of money to gamble with. So this is not $2 out of my pocket. This is $2 out of a listener whose name I've already forgotten.
Are
so
you folding up?
I'm going to ship that over to JP. He wins $2.
Silly.
Fair and square.
Well, I think all is right then. You know, this is the number he's always worn. He is going to be, listen, Tressway may be the captain, but Jaden's going to be the focal point of this football team, certainly for the next few years anyway. So I think good move, smart move on Tresses when it's all said and done. The number doesn't really mean that much. But guys do get attached to him, so I'm certain it wasn't easy.
Did you have a go-to number growing up? I kind of did. Jim Palmer was my favorite player, the pitcher for the Orioles. He wore number 22. Now, I couldn't wear that. Like, when I played for my club soccer team, the South Bowie Bears, I think I was number 6, and I just stuck with number 6. But when I got to high school and I could pick my number in both soccer and baseball, and 22 is not really a soccer number, I was 22 in soccer, 22 in baseball. And for some reason, I never had a Letterman jacket. Did you ever get a Letterman's jacket?
Of course, JP.
I never got the Letterman's jacket.
Of the tennis team. I had to have a Letterman's jacket. I was a big man on campus.
But our soccer team, which we were pretty good back when I played on the Eleanor Roosevelt soccer team, we had some sort of jacket. It wasn't a Letterman jacket. I think it was just a pullover. And I think I botched it. They ask you to, like, fill it out, and I put number 22 there, but I think you were supposed to put your graduation year, so everybody had 88 or 87 or 89 on their side, and I had the number 22. Yeah,
people are looking at it like you look, you're an alien. Like, what's going on here? What's going on with this
kid?
Thought
you put our number, so I kind of had a go-to number.
Number that I always put, and I didn't accomplish anything in sports, but when I played, you know, youth league stuff, was 14. I was a Pete Rose guy. So in my baseball jersey, I've had a 14. In my basketball jersey, I had a 14. A 14. That was my number.
Do you have one, Cakes?
No, I just
never?
Took whatever. Whatever number was available. You think I cared?
My youngest cares deeply and, like, goes into a whole thing.
Oh,
and,
really?
Yeah, yeah. So she's been wearing 4 for a long time. And it's weird. Like, you feel like certain numbers are good for, like, shorter kids. Other numbers are good on taller kids.
Yeah.
Like, there's a whole thing these kids get into.
Well, in some sports, a number is truly significant. In soccer, you want to be the 10, right? Your best player is generally number 10. My 7-year-old already knows that. We didn't have a number 10 to give away, but she wanted number 10 because her mom taught her.
Right.
My wife played in college, and she grew up playing as number 10, and she's already convinced Isabella that you want to be number 10 because that's the best player.
When Stevie did his recruiting trip to Marist, they did the bit where when you go into the locker room, they had a locker there, and it had number 11 hanging from the locker, right?
Okay, yeah, that's significance 11.
11 was the number he wore in high school.
Okay.
Okay? And, you know, gotten really used to that number, and I thought that was the coolest thing. You know, just lacrosse, you know, non-revenue generating sport, but it's cool that they went that extra mile.
But then when he got there, is he 41?
When they came to give out the numbers, they had actually admitted that they had already promised that number to another incoming freshman.
The double deal.
So, and that was fine. Yeah. You know, it was the thought anyway. They definitely appealed
they
to
already
our,
had recruited him. He already made his commitment.
They appealed to our, you know, whatever
emotional
sentiment
state.
About
sure.
that. And then Keegan ultimately gave him 41, and then I fell in love with 41.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and it worked out great.
Sure.
And Stevie actually said after his freshman year, maybe I'll change it. I go, you're not changing it. First of all, we bought a bunch of gear with 41 on it.
Right.
I'm not buying a bunch of other,
gotta,
like,
stick with it.
Like, parents, you know, sweatshirts with different numbers.
Yeah.
No, you're sticking with 41, and that ended up being great.
And speaking of buying gear, now Commanders fans, they have a jersey that they can feel confident buying. Like, for years, it's been like, whose jersey would you buy? Maybe you'd buy Terry McLaurin. You'd buy probably Jonathan Allen. But outside of that, whose jersey are you going to invest in? Now you can safely go out and plunk down your money on a number 5 Jaden Daniels jersey and feel confident that he's going to be here
and
for
you,
a while.
You guys kind of shoot away my argument that the team may be pushing the uniform number as soon as possible to sell jerseys.
No,
I think that probably is part of it, but I think the team encouraged it.
I didn't have a problem with the team encouraging. The problem I had with the idea that the team would pay. That's where I knew there was no way that was going to happen. Team's not going to pay $50,000 or $20,000 or something to a kid. No way they were going to do that.
I mean, maybe the team wanted him to wear 5 because that's been his number forever, but I think that this ownership regime, they're past just doing things to sell a few extra jerseys. They're not in it for the. I think they're
no,
in
I
it for the
that,
long haul.
I don't think they cared about that.
I don't think that they're hung up on stuff like that.
No, but they did go. Apparently, Quinn and Peters did go to him and say, hey, you could decide what you want to do.
Right.
If you want to give it up or not. And initially he had said no, and then he thought about it, and then, you know, ended up doing the right thing.
That's cool.
But they did approach him.
Yeah.
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 Yeah, I bought into it. Look, somebody tweeted that, and I was like, that makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
Because if I was the owner of the team, I would want to sell Jaden Daniels jerseys
well, you're gonna sell
as soon
them,
as possible.
No matter what number he is.
Yeah, but you're losing maybe if he subscribed to the wait 'em out theory, which was Keyshawn Johnson theory of wait out and see who gets cut and everything, well, you're losing months of potential revenue.
Yeah. They'll sell plenty of them.
They'll be okay.
And I think you,
not worried about that.
I think you could feel comfortable, like Cake said, buying it. Although I would have thought you could have, when you bought a Chase Young jersey, that you were going to have that for 10 years.
You probably did feel comfortable buying a Chase Young jersey
right?
when he's picked number two
and
overall.
We know those Robert jerseys were on fire for the longest time. Now you get them for like $5 at TJ Maxx.
I mean, I would be shocked if they're even on sale for $5.
Of course, Jaden's being compared to Robert Griffin III a lot, including his suit when he got drafted. But Robert has tweeted that he believes Jaden Daniels is far more ready for the NFL than he was when he came out.
He's right.
It remains to be seen.
I think he's right. I think he's right.
And you know what? That seems like a big step for RG3. like to admit that.
Well,
he's very much a me guy.
He is a me guy, but he's a weird me guy because he also gives out a lot of praise to other guys too.
Mm-hmm.
He's not really that big on tearing guys down. I mean, you can certainly find instances of it, but he's been tweeting like crazy about all these young quarterbacks, and he praises virtually all of them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, he tends to focus on the positive. I will give him that.
I think that's his whole podcast, whatever it is, RG3 and the ones, is to prop up those players.
Yeah, Valdez's theory about that kind of stuff, though, is that all those analysts now, they only do positive reviews because they don't want people coming at them and saying you suck.
Oh, is
Robert,
that what it
you
is?
Suck. You don't. Mm-hmm. So maybe it is his own narcissism coming back where Robert also wants to be praised.
Maybe that's at the
but
root of it.
But he's definitely being positive. Definitely. Mm-hmm. I noticed like he's like pumping up all these young guys and kind of points to their positive attributes, which is fine. We got enough people hating on us in comments, you know what I mean? Guys hear enough of it. I mean, who were some of the analysts that were you thought that were critical, but not like in a mean way, but objectively critical? I mean, I guess Merrill Hodge was critical, almost borderline mean, with this criticism of Drake May, I think.
There were Drake May got a lot of criticism. Jaden didn't get that much.
Mm-hmm.
You know, most of the people that looked at Jaden Daniels' film, they might say, okay, he like Bill Belichick, for example. Belichick said, you know, what a lot of people said, that he's got to work on throwing in the middle of the field,
mm-hmm.
that almost everything's to the outside of the field. The criticism of maybe scrambling too quickly. Mm-hmm. The guy's an unbelievable scrambler, but maybe he doesn't see the first read and he just takes off. Our guy, Zach Kruger, who I'm actually supposed to play golf with next week, pointed out that sack to pressure ratio.
Right.
So there are some people that find those things, but it's more like nitpicking, saying he's been a great player, but these are his weaknesses.
Yeah, these are things to look at, areas of concern. Yeah, no, people were generally pretty positive with Jaden. I'm just trying to think of analysts like Orlovsky. Who was Orlovsky? At the end of the day, I feel like he was all over the place.
Yeah.
Right? He was critical of some guys, and then he kind of came around on guys.
I think he was one of those guys that thought potentially Jaden Daniels could be better than Caleb Williams.
Mm-hmm.
I'm not sure where he finally landed, but Orlovsky, most people were, look, going back to the original point of the segment, Tressway said that there's more excitement than he's felt. I don't think it's reached RG3 levels because I do think there's scar tissue from the RG3 thing that people are more hesitant and a little bit more wait and see.
I think 30% of the fan base at least is scared that he's going to have like an RG3-like career.
Really?
Arc.
You think it's that big of a number?
Just because of they see the spindliness and they some of the run first stuff, that they're a little bit anxious. Look, he's a slender guy.
I think we're getting far enough away from RG3 where I don't know if that many fans really think about it that much.
Yeah, here's who does, Cakes. Remember how divided it was when Robert was here?
Sure.
I mean, honestly, a lot of it was along racial lines. No one likes to say it, but it really was. Mm-hmm.
Sure.
But the Kirk
not originally. originally everybody was RG3.
It went that way.
It started going south.
Yeah, it got really weird.
Yes.
It was really weird. But I would say that people that are still like Kirk guys, they're the ones that are going to bring up the RG3 comparisons. Like, not all of them. That's where like my 30% is coming from.
Right.
From the Kirk camp that are still not over that whole deal.
I don't know if it's 30%, but there's a good portion of the fans that it's not just RG3. It's RG3 plus the same old skins mentality that never, you know, nothing ever works out here, that they're afraid he could bust.
Right.
And look, mathematically, 50% of these guys bust. So just doing the math, Caleb Williams, Jaden Daniels, Drake May, Bo Nix, Penix, who am I missing? Doesn't matter.
JJ
McCarthy, out of the six guys, mathematically, just based on history, half those guys are going to bust. So there's a little fear.
Possibly.
800-636-1067 is the number, but it is official. Jaden Daniels will wear number five